everyone, and welcome back to DM Aesthetics YouTube channel. My name is Daniela, however you can call me Danny. I do want to thank everyone that has subscribed thus far to my channel. If you have not, of course, it is pretty easy. All you have to do is hit that subscribe now button below. So today we're going to get into DIY projects. Like I stated in my welcome video, DIY projects are not hard at all. So I kind of want to give you a step-by-step of how that goes. I will actually unpackage everything that I purchased for my DIY projects today. All of my essentials thus far have come from Amazon and also Lowe's. With Lowe's, I actually did a curbside pickup today. What I wanted to purchase off of Amazon, it wouldn't have gotten here on time. So I decided to do an order online and I went and did a curbside pickup. So I'm gonna unpackage everything so you can see exactly what the products look like, just in case you're wanting to buy them either off of my Amazon storefront or even within Lowe's. And today will also be a vase edition. So I will show different vases from different shapes, different sizes, and show you what can be done with those vases with everything that I purchased thus far for DIY projects. So let's get into it. So let's get into opening up our packages so we can see what type of DIY essentials we will necessarily need for our project. This is, of course, an Amazon package, so we're going to see what we have inside. I will give you first glance of what it looks like and if you necessarily want to purchase. So let's get into it. So as of what I'm seeing, this is a six-pack spray paint that I purchased off of Amazon. And I will show you guys exactly what it looks like. So you can do a screenshot. I will also list everything below. So this is a six pack of Rust-Oleum. I think that's how you pronounce it. So this is kind of a metallic spray paint that you can use necessarily for anything. It's not only just for vases, it's for different types of material, whether it is metal, whether it is plastic, glass, anything of this sort. So this is a six pack from Amazon and this is gold metallic, you guys. So we're going to get into that a little bit later. Let's move on to the next box. This is another Amazon box that I'm opening up, you guys, and let's see what is inside. Okay, so we have multiple items. This is crushed glass. People usually use crushed glass for canvases. If you want to create your own canvases that you hang up on your wall, this is one of the essentials that you might need depending on the type of canvas that you want. I like glittery over the top. So I love crushed glass, and we will get into this actually another day because we're not doing canvases today. Remember, guys, we're doing vases. Next, we have a paint set. A paint set is normally used for canvases as well if you want to do DIY projects for canvases. Also, you can use this as well for vases if you want to use it for vases as well. I'm not using this today for vases. I'm actually using this for canvases, so this will be used for another day as well, guys. So we're gonna put those two to the side because we're not using those today. We also have another box from Amazon. If you have not realized thus far, I am an Amazon shopper. I also have my own Amazon storefront where I have things that I would suggest or things, you know, that I necessarily think is cute. That's whether it's decor, DIY essentials, travel essentials, anything, you name it, I have it. So we have two boxes, not boxes, we have two packages, and I'm gonna open them so we can see what's inside, guys. Okay, So we have all of our essentials, and I guarantee you this is the same because I ordered two. So this is actually B7000, and we usually use this for canvases as well, vases. It helps when you're using super glue. Sometimes super glue isn't as strong, but this also helps. So we might be using this as well for a vase. We'll get into that later. And then it comes with your own little essentials, which is pretty cool. I know that I've used this specifically when I did a DIY project for my birthday outfit. I had a carnival theme. So with me adding feathers and diamonds, I used that and those actually stayed. So again, like I stated, this is more than likely the same thing, and it is. It's the same thing, guys. So then we're gonna move on over to Lowe's. Lowe's, I bought the Rust-Olam as well from Lowe's. These two colors were not going to be available on time for my DIY project. So this is metallic silver, gray, whatever you want to call it. And this is more of a matte black. So I'm doing a revamping in my back room, which is my office. So black is my go-to color. So that's why I bought this. But however, we will be using the black today. I'm not quite sure about the silver. I'm sorry, black. I don't know if I said silver or black, but we will be using the black today. I'm not sure about the silver, however, but we definitely will be using the black because a lot of my DIY projects that I'm going to be doing in the next few weeks will actually be into my new revamped office. So I bought two apiece, Rust-Olam, and then I also bought some Scotch blue tape. A lot of times we use this as well for canvases, vases. Like say for instance, if we're going to revamp or we're going to do a DIY project for a clear vase, maybe we do not want the full vase to be black, gray, or even gold. Maybe we still want it clear to show through a little. So we normally use this tape to kind of section it off. So when we spray paint and we peel the tape off, you will still see the clear portion or whatever color the vase is. If you're not wanting the vase to be fully covered or kind of give it an abstract type of feel, then this is the type of tape that you would necessarily use. And then I have other things such as like glue guns and things of this sort to help out with vases. I just do not have it right here in front of me. However, we will get into that and we will see a little bit later. So I cannot wait, guys. So I went and actually found another bag that consists of DIY projects. As you can see, it is from Michael's, and I will show you what's in it. However, a lot of the things that's in here we're probably not going to use today. So this is like paint brushes, is used for canvases and things of that sort. You can use it for your vases if you want a smooth finish, if you don't want a smooth finish. But these are, I actually went to Michael's and purchased these exactly for my canvases. So this is more like crushed glass. This is not glass. But this is more like crushed glass. If you would want like this type of color, it's normally for canvases as well. However, you can make a real funky, cool type of vase. So this is from Michael's as well, you guys. Now this is like diamonds. Who doesn't love diamonds? Who does not love diamonds? I will also put the names and everything of the DIY essentials that I bought, or just let you know where they came from, also in the comment section as well. But these are little diamonds. I don't necessarily think that we're going to use those for today. However, I wanted to show you these as well. You can never, you guys, you can never go wrong with too many glue sticks. You never know if you're going to mess up on a DIY project, or if you just want to start over, or you just do not like it. So you should always have so many glue sticks hanging around. We do know that they go out pretty fast, especially because the glue gun stays hot. So it's never a bad thing to have glue guns. I use the Gorilla Glue. So it helps with all of my DIY projects, so it doesn't look funky. It looks very much clean cut and something that you would want to store and actually stage around your home. So we will also have, this is this bling ribbon. A lot of people use bling ribbon for their vases. You just do not understand. It actually comes out cute. I got this from Michael's as well, you guys. So this is pretty cool as well if you want to use this for your vases too. Some more glue sticks. And this is some nickel-free iron ribbon. It's a chain. So people use this for their vases as well. It's used for multiple things. It's used for multiple things, but a lot of people use it for their vases as well. So I just wanted to give you a glimpse of what a DIY would look like. So I'm gonna break everything down. Cover, of course, my kitchen island. I don't wanna damage anything because like I said, today is vase day. So we're gonna be showing you, I'm gonna be showing you different vases, different styles on how you can actually do a DIY project for that vase. And it could be a possible centerpiece for your dining room table, even your kitchen island, who knows? So we're gonna get into that and we're gonna see how everything turns out, you guys. I'm excited. So guys, we're gonna start off with a small vase, a very small vase, something that we can necessarily practice on for our beginners. What we're gonna do is it's gonna be cool and it's gonna be simple. We're gonna make this one go. So we're gonna use a hot glue gun, and we're gonna use gold spray. So what we're gonna start off by doing is we're gonna just zigzag. It doesn't necessarily matter what type of order you go in, but we're gonna zigzag, we're gonna go all the way down, and we're gonna wait a little bit for the hot glue gun glue to dry a little bit, and then we're gonna spray paint over it to kind of give it that abstract feel. So let's get started, guys. So like I said, we're gonna go in a zigzag all the way down. It necessarily does not matter how you do it. It's up to you. It's your project. So everyone's project is not necessarily going to look the same. I'm gonna show you a little bit of what I've done so far. And like I said, I'm just going in a zigzag. Look, I'm already almost out of the hot glue stick that's in here. So let me grab another one very quickly and push it in there so we can keep going. But like I said, in a zigzag down, you can go left or right, right or left. Just so you can have an abstract feel on how this vase will turn out. You just necessarily want it to not, it can be any way that you want it to be. So it's not necessarily, like I said, everyone's is not going to be the same. Mine's is not going to look like yours. Yours is not going to look like mine. The only thing that matters is that do the end project, do you love it? Everything is not going to start off and be perfect, guys. So it's going to take a while. So we're going to go ahead and speed up the process. And like I said, we're going to wait on the glue to dry as well. We're almost finished with covering this vase with hot glue. And then like I said, we're gonna let it sit, cool off a little bit, and then we're gonna spray paint it gold and see how it comes out. Do we like it or do we not like it? So I'm gonna show you what it looks like with everything with the hot glue gun on it. Let me pick it up from the bottom because I do have a part that's still a little bit So it just looks like a whole bunch of hot glue, but we're gonna spray paint it and kind of give it an abstract feel. I think you guys are gonna love it. Maybe you wanna try it for, like I said, your kitchen island or even your dining room table. Now I will go ahead and say that this does take a lot of hot glue. So what I stated earlier within the unboxing all of the DIY essentials, you're gonna need a lot of hot glue. It took almost 5 hot glue sticks in order to complete just this small vase. So just imagine how much that it will take for a bigger vase. So make sure that you always have a lot of hot glue sticks so you will not run out in the middle of your DIY project, guys. So I'm just going in and filling up some of the holes that I necessarily see that I missed. But like I stated, everyone's is not going to look the same. As long as you love it, who cares? As long as you love it to be a centerpiece, whether it's for a coffee table, dining room table, kitchen island, as long as you love it. Maybe even you want to put it on a floating shelf or even just a regular shelf, a ladder shelf. This will probably go on a floating shelf since it is so small. I kind of want my floating shelf to stand out. My floating shelf is white, so I think that this will actually be perfect to go on a floating shelf. If you do not have a floating shelf, you can find anywhere that you would like for it to go. So I think it's cool enough, guys, in order for us to go ahead and start spray painting. So let's go ahead. I broke down my boxes that I got all of my DIY essentials out of, so I would not spray paint my kitchen island. I would be so upset at myself if I did that. So that's why I put down the extra leverage, so I will not kind of mess up my kitchen island. So we're gonna start. Like I said, this is gold. Let me show you guys again. This is the gold metallic rust alum. I think that's how you pronounce it. I'm not sure, guys. Correct me if I'm wrong. So we're going to start, shake it up a little bit, and we're going to start spraying. So I kind of want to give you guys what it looks like already. Look how cool that is. So it looks ugly on this side, but with the spray paint, I'm loving it already. So let's give it a little swirl and dirl. Make sure you get every area. If you guys want to wear gloves, it's perfectly fine. But I just want to show you guys what this will look like. I'm going to put it down and spray paint it that way. Like I said, I put the leverage down so I want to get my kitchen island. So that's what I'm doing, guys. I want you to see what this looks like. And if you miss anything, like I said, sway back and forth. Don't just stay in one spot, because this is going to make it more lumpy than the other side. So even it out with your paint. It's okay to even it out. Spray across. Don't just stay in one spot. But I think that we are finished, guys. I will give you guys I love it. Maybe yours turned out a little bit different than mine. I got a little bit of spray paint on me. I can easily go wash that off. But this will go onto my white floating shelf within my living room. And I actually love it. You can easily style it with any flowers. You can put the diamonds that I saw in there. Even if you want to use crushed glass, you definitely can use crushed glass. Only if you don't have kids. I know it would not necessarily be kid friendly, but if you do not have kids, you can actually use the crushed glass to add onto it. And I would suggest using the B7000 to kind of complete it with the crushed glass. So it'll stick. So you just won't have crushed glass all over your floors or anything like that. I know that it's not kid proof, so I necessarily would not suggest it to people that have small kids especially. But let me see. Should I be able to pick it up a little bit? I'm just going to give you guys a close up on it.
So I wanted to give you guys an up close of the finished product. It gives you off that abstract feel, guys. If you can see in the back where I have a white floating shelf in my living room, that is where this vase is going to go. I'm going to probably stick a few flowers in here just so it can stick out, you get what I'm saying, guys? But it's giving off this abstract feel. Like I said, yours might not look like mine's, however I love the way that mine's turned out.
Okay guys, so we're gonna move on to our next DIY project. This is totally different from the first one that we started off with, so this one is going to be more different, very different from our last one. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna tape down both sides with this blue tape to kind of stop the spray paint from sticking to that side. Not necessarily sticking, but make sure that it does not get within that area, because we're gonna do something within that area as well. So for this project, we're gonna use this vase. We're gonna use a Scotch tape. We're using the black matte, guys. We're also going to use the B700. And I know that I stated earlier that I probably was not going to use the crushed glass, but I am. So the crushed glass, it comes as a two-pack. It comes in silver and then also comes in gold. So I'm thinking that we're going to aim towards the gold, because like I stated, a lot of things that I'm going to be doing for my DIY projects will go into my black room in my office. My office will now be black, more than likely a little bit of gray, a little bit of white, and a little bit of gold, but mainly black. So this will be my product for this particular. So I might as well bring it to the front so you guys can see. I think that this one is going to also be pretty cool. So we're going to start off with the tape. We're going to section off where we do not want the black spray to go on the vase, okay? So I might as well lay it down and then just direct necessarily where I do not want that black spray to go. And then I'm going to show you guys how it's done once I finish. Make sure that you are in a straight line, guys. A straight line. So you won't do any zigzags or anything like that. You can take your scissors, make sure that it is down, and you're gonna make sure that that blue tape is, like I said, make sure that it is straight, because once you start spray painting, that black is not gonna touch the inside of that. So it's still going to be clear once we finish with the black mat. So we're going to turn it to the other side and we're going to do the other side and make sure that it is necessarily right behind it. So if you have to do any measurements, that's perfectly fine. And then also make sure that this side is straight as well. Use your scissors. Put it down. So both sides is basically double tape. You can see that it's even. It's double tape. So now we can actually go ahead and do the spray paint. We're doing black spray paint this time, guys. It's the matte and it's the Russo Lim as well. Like I said, I don't know if that's pronounced right. So correct me if I'm wrong, guys. Also, I still have the cardboard down, so I won't mess up necessarily my kitchen island. So let's see how this black turns out, guys. And like I said, remember to do a zigzag, go side by side. So one side doesn't look like it has more color than the other. I'm going to show you how it turned out, how it looks. This is how it's looking. It's dripping a little bit, so I'm not going to keep it that close to the camera. And we're going to turn it around. We're going to do it again. Make sure you're zigzagging, guys. Okay. So then we're gonna turn it this way. And we're gonna start the spray paint again. Mind you, like I said, it's more of a metallic finish. Then it's more of a matte finish than metallic. And if you get it on your hands, it's easy to wipe out because I got a little bit of the gold as well on myself, but all I did was use soap and water and I was able to get it off of my hands pretty easily. So don't worry about it. If you want to use gloves, you really can. But I'm loving the way this black is turning out. I'm not spraying a little too. I'm not pressing really hard on getting it out because I still don't want it to spray everywhere because we all know black gets very messy. So as of right now, guys, you cannot see the blue. However, we're gonna wait until the black dries and then we're gonna peel that blue tape off. And when you peel the blue tape off, you're gonna see that clear that the vase started off with. And that's where we're gonna use the V7000 and then we're gonna use the crushed gold glass to go in between it. Kind of give it like a wow factor pop. So it just won't be a regular vase that's just spray painted black. It's just something that I came up with off the top of my head, guys. I can't even lie to you. I just came up with it off the top of my head. So you can do it any way that you want to. Hey, if you want that just matte finish for your vase, that's perfectly fine. Everyone's project is necessarily not going to be the same. So we're gonna have to sit here and allow it to dry. And once it dries, we're gonna pull that blue tape off and then we're gonna see where we're gonna start with the crushed glass. I'm excited about this.
Okay, guys, this is what the vase looks like now that it is dry. Some parts might look like it's necessarily not dry, but it actually is. I turn it this way, but it's giving more of that matte type of finish. So we're gonna peel the tape and see how it looks up under the tape. And it's giving off black, of course, because the inside is a little black, but if I get a little close for you guys to see, you will see that it's not necessarily black. But it's going to be covered up anyways. So let me pull the tape off as well, and then I will show you guys necessarily what it looks like. So you can see that it is clear. You can see straight through it on the side. It's just a little bit dark to where you necessarily can't see it. But like I stated, we're gonna be using this B7000 and adding crushed glass so we can really sit it down, lay it on its back. And like I stated, we're going to use the B7000 to put on it where the light is at. Where the light form is at, and then it won't be necessarily messy because it comes like with a little screw, so it's not going to be necessarily messy. So we can start at the top, guys, and go zigzag like we did with the hot glue gun. So this is the adhesive glue. So with the adhesive glue, we're going to allow the crushed glass to stick to it. So I'm just going in a zigzag, making sure that I get every area. If you guys necessarily don't have this V7000 adhesive glue at home, like I stated, I can put the link in the comments for you to get it off of my Amazon storefront, or you can even just use the hot glue gun. The hot glue gun, I will tell you, with this, it's gonna take a little bit longer you getting down to the bottom of your vase. If your vase is as tall as mine, so it's gonna take a little bit more time and a lot of more hot glue. Because with that first vase that I did, you guys remember how small that was? Remember how small that was? But it took me about four hot glue sticks in order just to finish that small vase. So either or is perfectly fine, however you want it to work. But just make sure that you're necessarily covering up every area, because it's gonna go and put the crushed glass on top to where it'll stick, and then of course shake off the excess crushed glass so it won't be necessarily falling everywhere. And of course it's necessarily not kid friendly, kid material. So even if you do have kids and you want to try this, I would stay to put it somewhere where a kid could not grab it. But once you allow that excess crushed glass to get off of the glass, it won't be as bad as you would think that it would be. It's taking me a little bit longer because of course how tall the vase is, but we're almost done. So we can open up the crushed glass, guys. Started. All right, so we're finished. So we're going to use the gold crushed glass. I also got this off of Amazon as well. It came in a 2-pack. Oops, look, I'm already spilling. It came in a pack like this. I can also place the link below. And then we're just going to spray it. And then you'll be able to pick up the excess crushed glass, because yes, it does get a little bit messy. One more broom. So I'm just gonna go through and spray with. Put all of the crushed glass just to make sure that it covers up the spot so everything will necessarily come out to be even. So that's exactly what I did. I'm gonna show you all. Not that much got on the actual floor, but I'm gonna give you guys a close-up on how
this looks. Of course, it's a little bit messy, guys, but however, this is what it actually looks like laid on its back. Mind you, remember we used the adhesive glue, which is the B7000, and then we used the crushed glass also that I received from Amazon. So this is a close-up of what it will look like. I know that it looks a little bit messy at the moment, but I just basically placed all of the gold crushed glass on top just so it can even out when I decide to get the rest of the excess crushed glass. Now, of course, with me having this down, that helps a lot to where I can scoop up all of the excess crushed glass to use
for later. So, guys, what we're gonna do is we're gonna shake off this excess crushed glass just to see how it turned out. To shake off some of the excess, just to show you guys what it'll look like. And then I have like a little paint brush that I can use to sweep off some of the crushed glass as well. I already have one open, guys. So something like this, they can kind of get all of the excess. So we can actually stick this up. We got some on the back, but that's perfectly fine. We can get it off as well. But this is necessarily what it looks like. Isn't that cute? And then we're gonna do the back side as well. So you will have a brand spanking new. Let me get another paintbrush as well. And I think I actually got these paintbrushes from maybe Walmart or something to that extent. But it'll be able to get all of that excess crushed glass off. So maybe if you decide that you want to necessarily pick it off, that's perfectly fine. But it's coming off perfectly with a paintbrush. Some you will necessarily have to pick out, but that's what it looks like, necessarily the finish. And sometimes you might just want to scrape off the crushed glass as well, not too hard, so you can make it necessarily kid friendly. So it's kind of scraping off some of the crushed glass that's not stuck to the adhesive glue, which is perfectly fine. But even with me taking some off, it still looks great. Still looks great, guys. Okay? Now, this is a more messy project, of course, but it's going to be cute. It's already cute. Hopefully, you guys agree. So, we're going to do the same on the other side. We're going to do the same on the other side with adding the adhesive glue. I'm just picking off some of the crushed glass. So, but we will still have a finished product. So we're going to start down here since we already have a mess right here. So we're going to start down here. We're going to lay it on this opposite side, which is of course this side that we also had the tape on as well. And then we're gonna do the adhesive glue on that side too. So let's get to it. The same exact thing, a zigzag, guys. So we can make sure that the crushed glass sticks firmly. And like I stated before, you can either use this adhesive glue or you can also use a hot glue gun. I feel like the hot glue gun will necessarily take a little bit longer and you will need more hot glue sticks. So remember that in the future. So same zigzag, same thing that we did on the opposite side. In order to get the crushed glass to stick on that side as well. Y'all heard that little tone in my voice? I can blow a little bit. In the shower, mainly in the shower. Now this definitely, where I said that this one could be a centerpiece, this is definitely a centerpiece for a dining room table, even your kitchen island, your foyer, coffee table. This is definitely going to stand out. This black mat is going to stand out. It's going to stand out. I might honestly put it in my master suite, in my master bath. But since I stated earlier, I was changing up my office. It has to go in there. My master suite is already finished. So I can't be greedy. I have to put this stunning piece in my office. So we're almost finished, guys. I can't lie, you guys. It's hurting my hand. We're doing it a little squiggly. So this right here, I'm not gonna lie, it takes maybe in between 2 to 5 minutes. It just depends on how fast you move. My hands are quite small. And my hands crimp up pretty quickly. So, we're almost there. It's the squeezing and then the moving side to side.
No, seriously. Let's touch up on Shopify. It's easy.
I always do.
And we're almost there, guys. Okay, we're finished. So we can find the cap to this.
so we necessarily don't waste any more of our adhesive glue if I can find the top. Now, if I can't find the top, that's perfectly fine. I'll find it later, which it looks like I'm gonna have to find it later. Perfectly fine. So we're gonna go and we're still gonna use another bottle of the crushed glass. And this one is gonna be messy as well, however. We're just gonna sprinkle. And DIY projects will get messy, guys. It depends on what you're working with. It's going to be messy for us today because we are using spray paint and we are using crushed glass with adhesive glue, and a hot glue gun can even get messy from time to time as well. So we're going to make sure that we get everything like we did on the other side, sprinkle. Make sure you don't see any holes, any gaps. Make sure you get the bottom, the sides. Here we go. The same as the other side, we use two bottles of the crushed glass. Now, mind you, of course, we still have a lot of crushed glass. We just have to get it on up, which we'll do at the end of the video, or I might just do it off video because it might take a little time, especially with the crushed glass being so little. So we're gonna worry about that next. Then we're gonna put that back. Mind you, we already took off the tape. We can put the tape over here. And so now we can get them shaking and grinding. Look at that, guys. Okay, and we're going to use our brush. We're going to use this brush. This brush is more soft. We don't want to use necessarily that hard brush because that hard brush is probably going to take off a lot. And we don't want it to take off too much. So I'm going to show it to you and then we're going to clean it up. Let me show you both sides. This is both sides. This is literally the finished product, guys. Isn't that cute? Both sides are basically covered in crushed gold glass. Doesn't that look like something you'll see necessarily at IKEA, Home Goods? I took I think this was a $20 to $30 vase on Amazon. This vase is also located within my Amazon storefront, guys. All of my products necessarily came from Amazon. So the vase is from Amazon. The crushed glass is from Amazon. Now, the black spray, it did come from Lowe's. They do have this type of, or this color, spray paint on Amazon. It just was not going to come in time. So all products are actually located on Amazon within my Amazon storefront. The crushed glass and the spray paint will be located under my DIY essentials, and then the vase, of course, will be located under my vases and jars. But this is a piece that you will see necessarily at Home or Home Goods, and you're necessarily paying for a vase exactly like this, at least $50 to $75, at least. I wouldn't even say 50, you'll be paying way more than what it took me to make this vase. You'll be paying way more than that. I would say at least double. How much do you guys wanna bet? So I'm going to basically brush out the excess, and we're gonna push this to the side because we have a third vase that we're going to be putting together. It's gonna be something totally different, guys. Like I said, we're doing vases today and we're finished with this one. We're finished with this one. Now, I only have the flowers in here because I'm trying to decide what I want to go in here, but I know exactly where I want it to be. So I'm gonna finish this up And then I'm going to show you guys the finished product of all three towards the end. So we're going to go ahead and clean all of this up, and then we're going to start on our third
day. Hey guys, we are on to our last project for the day, DIY project for the day. And these are our third jars, vases, that we will be working on. Totally different from the first two. So with these two jars, we're actually going to combine them. We're actually going to make them stick together on purpose. So in order to do that, we're going to use a hot glue gun. We're also going to use adhesive glue. We're going back to this B7000. And when we actually put them together, let them cool off for a little bit, we're going to spray paint them this metallic silver. It's going to be so cute. In the middle of the vases or jars, whichever one you prefer, once they are combined, we're actually going to add a little bit of diamonds to them, kind of to hide the excessive either glue, whether it's the hot glue or whether it's the adhesive glue. But we're going to make it cute. We're going to spray paint it, and it's going to be metallic gray. But first, we have to combine them with the hot glue and also the adhesive glue. So let's get to it, guys. So we're going to lay both of them on their side, and we're going to start with the hot glue first. The adhesive glue is just going to necessarily be a backup just in case if the hot glue does not stick, okay? So we're only going to do it midpoint of the vase. It doesn't have to all be all at the top, but we do have to make sure that it is centered just enough so it will stick and that the vases are also, it tried to run away from me, guys. And to make sure that it's even, the jars are even. You want the jars to be even. So I have to get another, you see how quick hot glue runs out. I haven't even been using this for a good 5 minutes, guys. And then we have to kind of work a little bit fast on this project just so the hot glue won't necessarily dry before we try to stick it, okay? Make sure it does not roll. Now we're going to add the adhesive glue. Add a little bit of that. When this is still not a little, you can add, just make sure that it gets in there to where you know, where you feel like it will definitely stick to the other glass. So we're going to try it now, guys. Make sure that they are even. If they're not, make sure that they are. You can sit them up to make sure that they are even. Okay, they are even, and you make sure you push them together. And that's why I said that the diamonds that we will insert on the side will necessarily hide that excess glue, so it won't look like we did a DIY project. Okay, guys, so we're going to let it sit. Now, it doesn't have to sit that long. We know how quick glue dries. So after we do that, then we're going to do the metallic spray for that. So that was pretty quick and easy, you guys. I'm just making sure, even when I not necessarily force it, but it's sticking, right? So we want to make sure that it's sticking, which it is. Make sure of it. You can wiggle it a little bit or push it to make sure that it's not necessarily coming straight apart. So then we're going to use again the metallic gray. So it's going to give a more metallic feel of the spray paint. And like I said, go side to side, guys. So it's kind of giving off like a little marble feel. So if you necessarily don't like the marble feel, you can try another color. But I'm going to stick with this color.
just to see how it turned out. And then I'm gonna turn it so you can kind of see what it looks like. It's probably honestly better to use this color on maybe a white face. I have to be honest with you guys, because it's looking more marble. Do you guys want to necessarily switch it up? I think we can switch it up, guys. Do you think we should do the matte black, or should we do the gold? I feel like we can probably do the gold. I'm aiming more towards the gold. So we're gonna go with the gold instead, because it's necessarily still, it didn't want to come loose. It's giving more of a see-through type of feel. And like I stated, that probably works better with a white base. So let's see if it'll mix. Okay, I'm loving the gold now. Glad we switched that up. I'm loving the gold now, guys. Yeah, I'm loving the gold. Let's turn it around. We can move it around just a tad bit. But I'm loving the gold, guys. I'm loving the gold instead of the metallic. And just make sure you're covering up the gold as well. I mean, covering up the silver. I'm loving it. See, even though you might think, okay, well, this might work. You can easily change it up. There's nothing wrong with changing up your DIY project at the last minute, as long as you want to. If it's not looking right, make sure you have more options, guys. Make sure you have more options. That's what I will tell you. Because just imagine if I would have just had that metallic gray and I did not like that. I would have felt like I wasted my time. I would have felt like I wasted my time, guys. So I'm just going through and making sure that metallic gray is covered with the gold instead. So I'm gonna give it necessarily another coat to give it a more even feel. And we're still gonna stick with the clear diamonds just to give it more of a great feel to it, so we can cover up that excess glue that we use to combine both vases or jars, like I say, whichever one you would prefer to call it. So I think we're finished with this, guys. Okay, let me look, take a peek. Okay, like I said, every DIY project is not necessarily going to be perfect, but you have to make it perfect for you. Okay, so we're finished. We had a plan B, which worked out perfectly fine. So we're going to wait until the gold metallic spray actually dries. And once it dries, we're going to use the adhesive glue again, B7000, and we're going to use the hot glue stick in order to put these in the creases. Now this might take a little bit longer, guys, but to put inside of the creases in order to hide the hot glue and the adhesive glue we use to put the vases together, right? So let me take a peek. No, that's not what I'm needing. It's something else that I'm needing. So this is where these come in. This is where these came, these will come in, that was in a package with the hot glue, the adhesive glue. This will help with the picking up of the diamonds, so you won't necessarily have to pick them up with your hands. They are pretty small, I guess you can say, if you can see it. They're pretty small, but they're not that small. I've worked with this adhesive glue with smaller diamonds.
I can show you guys a little bit later. And then from the second project, how it was a little messy when it came to the gold crushed glass. Look, I was able to scoop up more than a jar and a half back. So really, for that tall vase that you see back there, we only necessarily use half of a bottle for that crushed glass. So it worked out pretty well, guys. So we can actually put this back in the box because we're not going to use it since we're on our last project. And normally what works for me as well, guys, is when I'm doing multiple DIY projects, I go in and I clean up the other projects or anything else that's left out hanging. And I know that I'm necessarily not going to use it for my latest project. So that's what I'm in the middle of doing at this moment. Okay, so we're going to wait on it to dry and then we're going to start working on it.
Guys, so the spray should actually be dry by now. I'm going to give you an up close of what it looks like. And you see the excess glue on both sides. So that's what we're going to do as of right now. We're going to use these. And we're going to use the adhesive glue. And then we're also going to use the utensil that it came with in the package. So we're going to actually lay it on its side. Either side is fine, whichever side that you feel. Like this side, you can tell it's dry. So I can lay it on its side, right? This side is necessarily not as dry because I did have to go back in and repaint due to the fact that I was trying to hurry up and start on the project and it was actually not dry. So I'm just gonna start like this, guys. I'm gonna put some adhesive glue right here on this side, and then I'm just gonna go in, since this one is already open, I'm gonna put a little adhesive on the end of my utensil so I will be able to pick up if it lets me. It might not let me with this type of tool. Maybe the other side will work. See how it wants to pick itself up, but it doesn't, but that's perfectly fine. So we can use our hands and just go in and make sure that it sticks to the adhesive glue that we already have sitting on there. If you want to add more as you go, that's perfectly fine. Just to make sure that the diamonds actually stick, guys. And then you can do more than one layer of what we're doing because I want it to look full. I just don't want it to look like I just stuck anything right here. So I want it to look full. I don't want it to look like it's a half project. So I'm making sure that I'm sticking it in on the line of the adhesive glue, and then I'm gonna add the glue on the opposite side as well. But make sure you don't stay a little, you're kind of bagged up from the adhesive glue because it will burn your eyes. I've learned my lesson, guys. Because it's very strong glue. So that's why it's used a lot in DIY projects, because it is pretty strong glue. Okay, hopefully this, what's the name? So I'm gonna show you guys up close what it looks like of me placing it in between. But we're gonna go in and we're gonna either double or triple it, okay? So I'm gonna add another coat to the opposite side and pack it on the opposite side. Pour a little bit more in my hand since it wasn't sticking to the utensil, which is perfectly fine.
So I'm going and doubling it, making sure that it still sticks to the adhesive glue. If it continues to move after you're placing the another stone, then you need to maybe add more glue or reconfigure it to where it's going to stick. And with this one, it doesn't look like it wants to stick. The last two doesn't look like they want to stick. So I'm gonna go back in and add some more adhesive glue. All right, so let's go back in and replace them. Because you want it to look full. You don't want it to look like you actually just placed this on here just to cover up something. So you want it to actually look like something, because you're gonna be staging this in your home. So, you know, when people come over, they definitely inspect your decor. So you wanna make sure that it's up to par, or, you know, up to your liking. It doesn't necessarily have to be perfect, because you have to think about it. A lot of times when we go inside of stores, that vase or that canvas can be either scratched or the paint is peeling to a certain extent, but you want it to still be to your liking. So you'll basically, you'll want to stage it in your home. It's not going to always. As long as you like it, that's what it's all about. So okay, so I went in. Let me put these down. I'm gonna show you the second one, right? You see how that second one is looking? Okay. And I messed this up a little bit on the side, but I can fix that later. I'm worried about the diamonds at this point. So I'm gonna go in and do another coat. And we're going to speed up the process, and then I'll show you guys the ending. Okay guys, so we are finished with our last DIY project of the day. I went ahead and finished doing the diamonds off camera, which I started on the front part. I just did the back part, and it was the same process. It actually took me a little bit over 30 minutes in order to finish it. I did have to repaint the vase or the jar, whatever you want to consider it as. I had to repaint it because once I picked up one side, it did kind of take some of the paint off. So that comes with DIY projects. Sometimes you have to repaint, sometimes you have to re-glue. It's not gonna always be perfect, but make sure that it's perfect for you. So I think that my next DIY project will be my bookshelf. It's a bookshelf / ladder, so a ladder bookshelf. I wanted to go into my black, white, and gold room within my office, because that's where it was at first. So they're like a smoke gray. I'm thinking about actually spray painting it gold in order to match the room with the full theme. So I'm looking into that being my next DIY project. I know that I definitely want to spray paint as well my desk. My desk is more of a smoke gray as well. So who knows what I decide to spray paint my desk as well. It's going to be a full, totally different room. You guys will see a before and after. So as of today, I'm thankful that you guys stuck it out with me in order to do DIY projects on these three vases that we have. The other two are located within the back. If you have not subscribed yet to my YouTube channel, it is pretty easy as always. Hit that subscribe now button below to show your love, support, and gratitude that I'm giving you guys these decor tips and trays. And if you have any decor tips and trays that you would like for me to record or even talk about within the next few of my videos, leave a comment below and let me know. Give me ideas. It's not just only about me teaching you. You guys can also teach me as well. So I really appreciate you guys for sticking it out with me. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you. Bye.